I folks, is there anyone down here who has not seen any fish yet?
It's cool out there, made up of a few different species.
Some of the more common fish in the preserve will also be the more common around the whole island in shallower waters closer to shore, which is where we are. They include the opal eye, probably the fish you've seen most of so far, a round, dark grayish colored fish with a white spot on its back, who get their name from the pretty blue opalescent color of their eyes. These opal eyes, they're scavengers, they have small mouths, they'll feed on anything they can find, including a lot of the algae growing on the reef, the vegetation you see growing down there, small invertebrates in the water, and of course the opal eye in the preserve, that they aren't specifically feeding on the food that we give them on a daily basis, little pellets. Pelletized fish feed for saltwater fish is what we feed these guys. A lot of bass out there as well. Our calico bass have a pattern of white spots that cover the length of their back. Kind of appear to make a checkerboard-like pattern, resemble checkerboard-like pattern. These calico bass have big, bright eyes, very colorful eyes as well, seem to change color with the sunlight. Large mouths in there, a lot of small but sharp teeth. Those teeth make the calico bass the carnivores of Lugger's Cove. They feed on smaller fish, and occasionally squid and the crab that they manage to catch. These calico bass can reach lengths of up to 28 inches. They've been known to weigh up to 3.5 pounds and have an amazing life expectancy of 34 years. Calico bass are also the best tasting fish we usually find in our preserve. They're known for their sweet taste, which has earned them the nickname the sugar bass. They are not found in restaurants or fish markets. They are a sport fish, which means you cannot commercially buy or sell them. When you eat a calico bass, you have to go out and catch them yourself. Also, blue perch among the big school out there might resemble the opal eye there after all, the related part of the perch family. This blue perch, though, has a crescent-shaped tail, which give them their names, the half moon. And although mostly blue, they have a silverish belly, silver color, near the bottom half of their bodies. Again, that's the half moon. And the Garibaldi, the beautiful bright orange fish, you might be familiar with them already, pretty popular, well known. The Garibaldi is, after all, the state fish of California, or state marine fish, a protected species, which means you can't harm or collect them. If you go fishing anywhere along the California coast, catch Garibaldi, you gotta release them, set them free, otherwise you could end up with some pretty heavy fines coming your way. Garibaldi are part of the damselfish family, which naturally make them aggressive, territorial species, although small, they're fearless, they're known to harass them in divers and snorkel groups that get too close. Reach our second stop near the other end of the preserve. We'll feed the fish one more time out here and give you guys one more feeding frenzy show to enjoy.